Welcome to all. Myself, Professor Deshmukh MS, presenting the theory lectures based on the response of damped system under the harmonic motions. So, what is a damped system? Damped system, everybody knows that the system which having there is a resistance to the motion, that is called a damped system. And harmonic motion, something that excitations is all about. So this is the case. Now this is the case of the force vibration or damped vibrations which contain the spring mass system, which having the mass M, the spring is attached, damped system that resistance is provided by means of the damper having the damper, the factor C. So figure showing that equivalence of the spring mass along with the damping force, the damping force which oppose the motion, the what is the role of spring? Spring, role of spring is to regain its original condition, that is called as what? The spring element, that is the or component that is known as what? Spring. C is the damping factor or damping coefficient rather. When we are applying the particular force, that is known as the F0 sin omega t. Kx and that of your C x dot F0 sin omega t, this is external forces. External excitation force, we can say that Kx, that is the spring force due to deflection of x values. Cx dot, x dot means velocity. So Newton's second law, what we got here, mx plus cx dot, mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx, that is equal to F0 sin omega t. My solution of equation 1 consists of the complementary functions part and part 2 is known as a particular integral. The complementary function part of equation number 1 is obtained by setting the equation to 0. The derivations for complementary functions part was done in the damped free vibration chapter. So x is equal to xc plus xp. This is the equation number 2. Now comparing equation 1 and 2, what we got here? The complementary function solution given by the following equation, that is xc is equal to a to e raised to zeta omega n t sine of under root of 1 minus zeta square omega n t plus psi 2. So this is equation number 3. Now from this equation number 3, the two constant can be determined by initial conditions. So this particular give and determinant, the vector method, will have the more insight into the analysis, that xp is equal to x sin omega t minus phi. So xp is equal to omega x sin omega t minus phi. So that's the case. Finally we got the x F0 sin omega t in bracket omega t minus phi plus pi, that is equal to 0. Now this is a vector diagram. It shows that F0 is the external forces acting phi is the phase angle, omega t, this is the angle, kx, this is the spring board, m omega square x, p omega x. Okay, so these are the cases. The displacement lags behind the impressed force by an angle phi. So the spring force is always opposite in the directions to the motions. So this is the case. Again, we have to consider these two. That is the method, the damping conditions to be elaborate. Now these are the examples where we have to find out the answers. Now come to our point. Following points are observed from the vector diagram. The displacement lags behind the impressed force by an angle phi. Spring force is always opposite in the direction to the displacement. Damping force always lags the displacement by 90 degree. The damping force is always opposite to the direction of the velocity. Inertia force in phase with the displacement. So these are the four points or observation after the vector diagram. It's subjected to the force. Also, operation. The following points are observed from the vector diagram. The displacement lags behind the impressed force by an angle phi. The spring force is always opposite in the direction to the displacement. The damping force always lags the displacement by 90 degree. Damping force is always opposite in direction to the velocity. Inertia force in phase with the displacement. So, the dead position of the vectors and here the magnitude do not match with the time. On the vector diagram, one can obtain the steady state amplitude and the phase angle as follows. Okay, so we have got these kind of things. Very simple. Magnification vector, we got that x upon xt. Okay, and this particular graph shows the frequency response and phase angle plots the system subjected to the force vibrations.